What is up, people? Welcome back to Blue Chip Prospect for another scouting report. Today we are taking a look at the big boy Anton Silayev, and just before we start this thing, don't be surprised if the next couple scouting reports are a bit shorter. I'm trying to make these videos a little bit shorter and a little bit more pacey and see where it goes from there. You know, I'm just trying to find a sweet spot to make these videos as good as I possibly can. But as always, enough chit-chatting, and let's get this thing started right away. Alright, so Anton Silayev is a giant Russian left-shot defenseman who stands at 6'7" and weighs in at 207 pounds. He's still 17, being born on April 11, so overall he's some kind of specimen, and it's easy to see why teams are salivating at the idea of drafting him. In terms of ranking, he's a little bit all over the place, from number 2 on the Hockey Network's list and Bob McKenzie's ranking, to 15 and 17 by the other Hockey Network's list and Smart Scouting rankings respectively. I'm not totally against people placing him outside their top 10, I understand it, but if we are real here for a second, he's going very, very early in the draft. Teams aren't going to pass on that type of player profile too many times. When it comes to stats, the baby giant has 11 points in 63 games, and he's had those 11 points for a while now. At the time of writing these bullet points, he's had 18 consecutive pointless games. The production was outstanding for a 17-year-old defenseman in the KHL for the first third of the season, but it really calmed down now. But he still has the most points for a first-year draft-eligible defenseman from the KHL, like ever. And he's third in point per game for a defenseman with more than 10 games played. So those numbers, they look great, but in my honest opinion, I think they bring very little value when evaluating the player. He's someone you have to watch and forget about this best point production in the KHL ever thing to build an opinion that makes sense. At least, that's what I think. But the fact that he's averaging 15 minutes of ice time and then 1 minute 39 of power play time over 60 games in a season as a 17-year-old on a team that isn't a bottom feeder is extremely impressive. So the production, I kinda leave it out, but the time on ice gives us a good indication of where he's going. When I said that I would change the way I grade defensemen's tools in comparison to forward this season, and that it wouldn't always make sense with the ranking, that's basically what I meant. A guy that projects as a high-end skater with high-end defense and physicality should probably be higher in my ranking, especially with elite intangibles when we match his physical profile to his tools, and when we add his rocket-like progression from last season to this season, or even from the beginning of this season to now. But I have too many questions when it comes to his transition game and his play with the puck on his stick. I gave him an above average grade for his breakout and transition, but that's 100% a projection. The tools and potential is there for it and even more, but right now it's still a bit questionable. Same with his offense game, but he's playing in the KHL. We can say what we want about the Exodus, but it's still the KHL. I can't expect him to dance around the other team like Yakimchuk does in a dub. Those are two very different levels of hockey. For Silayev, the skating is by far his most impressive attribute. When we consider his 6'7" frame and how light and easy it makes it look, it's pretty impressive. He has great skating mechanics and posture, which allows him to explode with just a few strides and create separation from the first layer of pressure. David St. Louis from Elite Prospect digs a little bit deeper into what makes him a great skater in his video, if you guys want a little bit more depth on this particular tool. Silayev is also light enough and agile enough to shake off forecheckers when he gets the puck in a bad spot, but I find that it's probably better if he doesn't. It's like he has the athleticism to escape pressure, but not necessarily the reading speed to recognize it. Sometimes he just willingly skates into pressure for no apparent reason. As much as he is a great skater going forward, I think he's an even better skater going backward. He's a fantastic skater going backward. And there's no one he can't match, and no one can catch him mid-crossover and create space from that. My only issue with his skating is how much ice he takes to accelerate going backward. It's funny because when I was a left defenseman and I used to take half the ice too to accelerate backward with a sharp angle in my crossover, just like him. And I remember being taught to keep it tighter and stay within a stick length of the attacker. I was putting stick down on the ice and practice making sure that I wouldn't go over the sticks while accelerating backward. But anyway, he's a great skater, and if one element can really open his game in transition and offensively, it will be his feet. Just need to work to get his eyes in sync with his feet, see what's open and what is not, see if he can actually open something by using his high-end mobility. So look, in the last 28 days, 61.7% of you watching my stuff aren't subscribed. Like, what do I gotta do? But honestly, if you like the content and you come back for it, which is more than half of you, you can't really lie to me, YouTube tells me everything, I'd appreciate the support. The more you like and subscribe, the more my content is pushed to new people, the more my content is viewed, and the more I get dopamine rushes, and it also helps the channel. It's simple, no? But anyway, please like and subscribe. The way I see it, I think Silayev has what it takes to be a top shutdown defenseman in the NHL. Of course, it's not perfect right now in the KHL, but the foundation is there for a solid 25 minutes a night defenseman. I think he is getting more and more balanced by the day. I rewatched 3 games before putting down some bullet points for this video, and the difference between October and November and now is pretty significant. He's less like a headless chicken, if you want. Way more like composed and calculated. At the beginning, he would just try to crush attackers every chance he got, getting loads of space between him and them and close down on them with violence. Now he's a little bit more tame, even though he's still an aggressive defender. He now understands how to leverage his tools, how to use his gigantic reach and strip the puck away, or to bat the puck in the neutral zone even when he's behind the play. He understands that if he got caught flat-footed, it's better for him to use his skating and his reach to lock the attackers to the outside instead of trying to hit the guy no matter what, and most likely get stuck out of the play anyway. So there was a significant progression in his defense without losing the edge that he's got. He still closes with force on players against the rush, he's still a very aggressive and doesn't give his blue line easily, and he still smooches player against the board with nowhere to go for them, but surprisingly isn't that great at gaining back control of the puck from the board. On the defensive side, he's going to be very, very, very good. Again, using his reach, his body, he can put stick on puck that most can't. He can cover so much ice and space with his stick and just a few strides. His area of effectiveness is just gigantic. He can lose a race to the board or to the corners and still bat the puck to a teammate. He's got a little bit of everything. In front of the net, he boxes out players aggressively and easily. He locks player's stick for deflection and rebounds, and the same thing with off-puck player driving the net. He can lock them up very effectively. Overall, I expect him to become a very hard player to play against in the NHL, and the player that just eats minute night after night. As of this moment, I am not the biggest fan of his overall breakout choices and transition game. Like I said previously, the tools are there for a future player who can move the puck from the back end to the offensive zone very effectively. It's a question of reads and decision. Maybe a little bit handling too. A bit like Reinbacher last season, he's not a fluid handler, but probably not as much a limiting factor in his case. But anyway, if he gets those sorted out, he'll be a player that is probably more than a grade 7 in terms of transition. But he's not out of the woods yet, and there's plenty of work to do and experience to gain. He has the skating to move the puck himself from deep in his own zone, and he has the passing to make clean, crisp passes to players on the move between layers in the neutral zone. By combining his skating and his passing, he can become an unpredictable breakout machine if he stops skating himself into forecheckers. I don't have much else to add here, since it's very much a work in progress, and that without a step in his decision making and the speed at which he can read the play, it's not gonna advance much further. But in the case that he does take a step in one or both those mental attributes, then we got a real player. You know, sometimes things just don't make sense. I have his offense rated at 6.5 and his transition rated at 7, but I like his offense better. At least right now. And the best way for me to explain the complicated mental gymnastics my brain goes through to arrive at those numbers is that I feel like we have a somewhat complete picture of what he can do offensively. He is what he is, and I don't see what he will improve that will significantly make him better. Don't get me wrong, he will get better and he will improve parts of his game that will help him be more productive. Maybe he ends up in the 35-45 range, but Compared to the transition part of his game, I can identify two or three attributes where he needs incremental improvements to get big results. I cannot identify the same thing offensively, and that might be more on me than on him. Maybe he's way better than I see, but I can only say things the way I see them, and honestly, sometimes putting numbers on stuff just don't make sense anyway. Offensively, he does do some small little things that I think will help him put up points on the board in the NHL, but I don't see a big point producer at all. He's good at moving players around by scanning east-west to create space on the ice. He likes to join the rush a little bit and sometimes even lead the rush, but it's not a consistent occurrence. He even sometimes finds pocket of space lower in the zone and jump in it to make a play or shoot the puck. His shot is average at best right now. I prefer his wrister over his slap shot, but both are just okay or NHL average. He's also a fine passer without being an overly skilled passer. He can send the puck through a little bit of traffic, but he also sometimes misses on the simplest of passes, especially when he's on the move. He's a far better static passer than an in-motion passer. When he leads the rush, the puck often goes nowhere, probably too many times. On the other hand, when he's posted at the blue line, he can send precise passes. So offense isn't what his game is all about, but we have a good idea of where he is going with that and how he reads the play in front of him. Because I already talked about his physicality in the defense part of the video, I'll just glance over it here. But what's important to know is that he has all that it takes to become a force and dominate physically in the NHL. A lot of his hits aren't clean right now, he falls on the ice with the other player too often in my opinion, but the foundation and the willingness is there. He just needs to find the balance, the right balance, and when to go all in and when to just stop the attacker and get possession back. But overall, he's very aggressive along the board, he'll make you eat his Sherwood in the crease, and he can hit like a train. With his size, his skating, and some work on his timing, he really can be that player that is hated by many, many fan bases. So there it is, I think Silayev has everything to become a top pairing defenseman, but it's also important to put his numbers into perspective. With the beginning of the season he had, you would think he's the next headman or something like that, but that is not the case. At least, it's not the direction in which he is going, but nonetheless, what he has accomplished this season is nothing short of impressive, especially since he's played a lot on his offside, which is an additional challenge for a 17-year-old kid playing in the KHL. When you take into consideration his physical profile, his tools, his play, I'd be very surprised if he isn't gone in the top 5, even though I have him at number 8 right now. There's just too much to work with for teams to pass on him, so he'll be gone very, very early in my opinion. And in terms of comparison, he's another player for who it's really, really hard to find an NHL comparison. There's no perfect match in terms of style. Obviously, there's also not a lot of 6'7" players who can skate and cover ice like he can, but I think someone like Jacob Trouba can be a good comparison in some ways. Big and smooth skating defenseman with tons of big hits on the radar. Not the most prolific offensive player past the offensive blue line, but can still make things happen. I think Trouba definitely has the heavier shot, but in some ways it works. But on the other hand, I still feel like it's a very wonky comparison, so take it with a grain of salt. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one. Peace.